So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you can ask any doubt and you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed on this group. And you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which is with respect to the State Health Index 2021 released by Niti Aayog. So yes, question number one is, which international organization has provided technical assistance in developing the State Health Index titled Healthy States Progressive India? So what is the title of this index? Healthy States Progressive India. It has been released by Niti Aayog. And the question is that which international organization has provided the technical assistance? So question number two, guys, is also based on this index. And now let's talk about this index. So Healthy States Progressive India index has been released by Niti Aayog. And World Bank has provided technical assistance. You can see here, World Bank has provided technical assistance in developing this index, and all these things are done under the guidance of Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. So it has been released by Niti Aayog under the technical assistance of World Bank, under the guidance of Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Mansukh Mandavia. All right, and this index ranks states and UTs based on their performance in the health सेक्टर में जो स्टेट्स और यूटीज है उनका कैसा परफॉर्मेंस रहा है उसके बेसिस पे ये इंडेक्स रैंक करता है स्टेट्स और यूटीज को. ऑलराइट, नाउ लेट्स टॉक मोर अबाउट दिस रिपोर्ट, दिस इंडेक्स. सो रिमेंबर, दिस इंडेक्स इज बेस्ड ऑन 24 इंडिकेटर्स इन थ्री डोमेन्स. देर आर 24 इंडिकेटर्स इन थ्री डोमेन्स. एंड वट आर दीज थ्री डोमेन्स बाई द वे? नंबर वन इज हेल्थ आउटकम्स, नंबर टू इज गवर्नेंस एंड इन्फॉर्मेशन, एंड नंबर थ्री इज key inputs and processes. Do remember the name of these three domains: health outcomes, governance and information, key inputs. All right, this is important. Now what is the reference year for this index? Reference year, guys, for this index is 2019-20, and the base year is taken as 2018-19. What is the base year? 2018-19. And what is the reference year? 2019-20. Very important. And the states are categorized into three categories: larger states, smaller states and union territories. And do remember, West Bengal did not participate in this index, and for Ladakh as UT data was not available. So is index mein aapko Ladakh aur West Bengal nahi milega. You will not find West Bengal and Ladakh. West Bengal did not participate. For Ladakh data was not available as a separate UT. Moving ahead to the rankings. Now these are just some important points from the rankings. Number one, among all the larger states, Telangana is the only state that demonstrated strong overall performance as well as incremental performance. Matlab, Telangana is the only state which has secured a good rank in the overall performance, and also it has shown increment over the लास्ट ईयर. मतलब जो पिछला या जो इसका पिछला इंडेक्स था, दिस इज द फोर्थ एडिशन, जो पिछला इंडेक्स था उसके रिस्पेक्ट में इंप्रूवमेंट हुई है तेलंगाना में. सो तेलंगाना एक अकेला ऐसा स्टेट है जहां पे ऐसा हुआ है. मोस्ट नेगेटिव इंक्रीमेंटल चेंज अमंग लार्जर स्टेट, इट इज कर्नाटका -1.37%. मोस्ट नेगेटिव इंक्रीमेंटल चेंज अमंग स्मॉलर स्टेट, इट इज गोवा -12.68%. एंड मोस्ट नेगेटिव इंक्रीमेंटल चेंज अमंग यूटीज, इट इज चंडीगढ़ -10.85%. ओके, सो ये तीन पॉइंट्स याद रखना, दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ये मोस्ट नेगेटिव वाला पूछा जा सकता है. नाउ मूविंग अहेड टू द रैंकिंग्स, सो इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द लार्जर स्टेट, बेस्ट परफॉर्मिंग स्टेट इज केरला फॉलोड बाय तमिलनाडु एंड तेलंगाना. ऑलराइट, केरला स्कोर इज 82.20. एंड बेस्ट इंक्रीमेंटल परफॉर्मेंस दिस ईयर वॉज शोन बाय उत्तर प्रदेश, एंड अराउंड 5% का इंक्रीमेंट हुआ है इसके हेल्थ इंडेक्स में, followed by Assam and Telangana. So you can see here, Telangana among the largest state is at rank 3 in the best performing states in the overall performance, and it has also secured rank 3 in the best incremental performance. So Telangana is the only state among all the largest state to do this. Talking about smaller state, so best performing state is Mizoram, followed by Tripura and Sikkim. Tripura and Sikkim, and best incremental performance may be Mizoram is at number 1. This is very important. This can also be asked. Best overall performance may be Mizoram among the smaller state. It is number 1. While in the best incremental performance also, Mizoram is number 1, followed by Meghalaya and Nagaland. Talking about UTs, so Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, ye ek hi saath liye gaye hain, kyunki ab we all know ye dono UTs merge ho chuke hain. So Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu is at number 1 in the overall performance, followed by Chandigarh and Lakshadweep. Talking about the incremental performance, so Delhi is number 1, followed by Jammu and Kashmir and Lakshadweep. ठीक है, ये सारा याद रखने हैं. ठीक है, मैं इसमें से ये नहीं कहूंगा कि क्या इंपॉर्टेंट और क्या इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है. इसमें से कुछ भी पूछा जा सकता है. दे कैन आस्क एनीथिंग, बिकॉज दीज डेज जो क्वेश्चंस होते हैं वो डायरेक्ट नहीं होते हैं कि विच स्टेट इज द बेस्ट परफॉर्मिंग स्टेट. ऐसा क्वेश्चन आजकल नहीं आता है. ऑलराइट, सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. देन क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज विच इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैज प्रोवाइडेड टेक्निकल असिस्टेंस. सो इट इज वर्ल्ड बैंक, ऑप्शन ई. World Bank is the correct answer, guys, to this question. World Bank is headed by Mr. David Malpass. Question number 2. Consider the following statements with respect to 4th edition of State Health Index released by Niti Aayog, and you have to identify the correct statements. So the index is based on 26 indicators. No, there are 24 indicators. Total kitne indicators hai? 24 indicators hai in 3 domains. In 3 domains. Alright. Best performing state among largest state is Kerala, absolutely correct. Best incremental performance among smaller state is Mizoram, this is also correct. And best performing state is also Mizoram among the smaller states. West Bengal did not participate in the index. Yes, this is also correct. So 2, 3 and 4 will be the correct answer, option B. Only 2, 3 and 4 is the correct answer, guys, to this question. I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 3. In which district of Jammu and Kashmir, Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has organized the first ever Jammu and Kashmir Real Estate Summit 2021. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs is headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri, and he is also the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Remember, this Real Estate Summit 2021 has been organized by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs in collaboration with Department of Housing and Urban Development of Jammu and Kashmir. And it has been organized in district Jammu. Kahan pe? Jammu mein. And remember, during the summit, various launches were there. Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs launched various things. And number 1 is auction of assets portal. Number 2, affordable rental housing complexes scheme. Number 3, Jammu and Kashmir RERA portal. RERA stands for Real Estate Regulation Authority. And Jammu and Kashmir Housing Mission portal. Inke baare mein detail mein jaane ki there is no need. There is no need to go into the details of all these four. Just remember, these four things were launched during the Real Estate Summit 2021 held in Jammu and Kashmir by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So therefore, the correct answer is what? Option D, Jammu. It was organized in Jammu. So talking about Jammu and Kashmir, so Manoj Sinha is the Lieutenant Governor. Manoj Sinha is the Lieutenant Governor in Jammu and Kashmir. Recently, Srinagar. Srinagar was added to the UNESCO's Creative List Network, Creative Cities Network 2021. Jammu and Kashmir administration recently launched eCop mobile app. Jammu and Kashmir was ranked number 1 among all the UTs in FSSAI's Food Safety Index. Food Safety Index release hua tha FSSAI ka, usme Jammu and Kashmir was ranked number 1. Alright, Jammu and Kashmir administration recently signed an MOU with Dubai for real estate development. Alright, so these are some recent news about Jammu and Kashmir. And now, can you tell me, recently a bird was announced as the UT, you know, bird of Jammu and Kashmir. Okay, so can you tell me the name of that bird? Write down in the comments. Moving ahead to question number 4. During his visit to Himachal Pradesh, Prime Minister has laid foundation stone of Luhri Stage 1 hydroelectric project. Identify the incorrect statements with respect to the project. Here you have to identify the incorrect statement with respect to the project. सो वेरियस हाइड्रोइलेक्ट्रिक प्रोजेक्ट्स, बहुत सारे हाइड्रोइलेक्ट्रिक प्रोजेक्ट्स का फाउंडेशन स्टोन रखा गया, बहुत सारे का इनॉग्रेशन हुआ. सो वेरियस हाइड्रोइलेक्ट्रिक प्रोजेक्ट्स वर इनॉग्रेटेड एंड फॉर वेरियस हाइड्रोइलेक्ट्रिक प्रोजेक्ट्स द फाउंडेशन स्टोन वॉज लेड डाउन बाई द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ड्यूरिंग हिज विजिट टू मंडी, टू मंडी इन हिमाचल प्रदेश. एंड ओवरऑल जो टोटल कॉस्ट, टोटल प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट है इन सारे ही हाइड्रोइलेक्ट्रिक प्रोजेक्ट का, दैट इज हाउ मच, 11,000 crores, राइट. एंड आउट ऑफ ऑल दी प्रोजेक्ट्स टू इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट, टू आर मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट. लूरी स्टेज वन हाइड्रोइलेक्ट्रिक प्रोजेक्ट विच विल बी कंस्ट्रक्टेड ऑन रिवर सतलुज इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट शिमला इन कुल्लू, एंड द टोटल कैपेसिटी इज हाउ मच, 210 मेगावाट. नंबर टू इज धौला सिंध हाइड्रोइलेक्ट्रिक प्रोजेक्ट विच विल बी कंस्ट्रक्टेड ऑन रिवर ब्यास इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट हमीरपुर, एंड टोटल कैपेसिटी इज हाउ मच, 66 मेगावाट. ओके, सो इन दो के बारे में याद रखना है, बाकी जितने भी हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक प्रोजेक्ट है उनके बारे में पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है. सो दिस क्वेश्चन गाइज इज रिगार्डिंग लूरी स्टेज वन हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक प्रोजेक्ट. सो इट विल बी कंस्ट्रक्टेड ओवर रिवर सतलुज, एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. इट इज लोकेटेड इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट हमीरपुर, नहीं हमीरपुर में नहीं है, हमीरपुर में दूसरा वाला है धौला सिंध. इट इज इन शिमला इन कुल्लू, शिमला एंड कुल्लू. इट विल कवर टू डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स, शिमला एंड कुल्लू, एंड इट्स कैपेसिटी इज 210 मेगावाट. दिस इज करेक्ट. सो ओनली टू, ऑप्शन बी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर, ओनली टू. एंड हिमाचल प्रदेश चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ कोर्स इज मिस्टर जयराम ठाकुर, जयराम ठाकुर. एंड रिसेंटली शिमला, शिमला फ्रॉम हिमाचल प्रदेश वॉज रैंक नंबर वन इन द नीति आयोग SDG अर्बन इंडेक्स. नीति आयोग SDG अर्बन इंडेक्स में शिमला वॉज रैंक नंबर वन. एंड वर्ल्ड्स हाइएस्ट इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल चार्जिंग स्टेशन वॉज इनॉग्रेटेड एट काजा, काजा विच इज इन द लाहौल एंड स्पीति डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश, राइट. एंड ऑफकोर्स इन हिमाचल प्रदेश यू विल फाइंड द ग्रेट हिमालयन नेशनल पार्क, द ग्रेट हिमालयन नेशनल पार्क. यू विल फाइंड द सिंबल बारा नेशनल पार्क, सिंबल बारा. यू विल फाइंड द पिन वैली नेशनल पार्क, खीर गंगा नेशनल पार्क एंड एटसेट्रा, खीर गंगा नेशनल पार्क. एंड ऑफकोर्स स्नो लेपर्ड, स्नो लेपर्ड इज द स्टेट एनिमल ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश. ओके, सो ऑप्शन बी ओनली टू इज द करेक्ट आंसर हियर. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 देन. कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द SHG बैंक लिंकेज प्रोग्राम एंड यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाई वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द SHG बैंक लिंकेज प्रोग्राम. इज इट अ न्यू प्रोग्राम, इज इट अ न्यू इनिशिएटिव? नो, इट इज नॉट अ न्यू इनिशिएटिव. वी आर डिस्कसिंग इट बिकॉज रिसेंटली the annual awards for performance of banks under SHG bank linkage programs were announced, and the top performing bank was Union Bank of India, followed by Punjab National Bank, Indian Bank and State Bank of India. So these four banks were awarded, and number one is Union Bank of India, followed by Punjab National Bank, Indian Bank and SBI. Now let's talk about the SHG bank linkage program. So remember, it was launched by NABARD in the year 1992 for providing financial services to the unreached and underserved poor households of the nation. हमारे देश के जो unreached, जिन तक financial services नहीं पहुंची है या कम पहुंची है, उन तक financial services provide कराने के लिए this program was launched by NABARD in the year 1992. And this program was recommended by a committee which is known as SK Kalia Committee. ठीक है, committee का नाम याद रखना, SK Kalia Committee. And any SHG, whether it is registered or unregistered, is eligible. But there is a condition that SHG should be engaged in promoting saving habits among their members. ठीक है, मतलब वो SHG, किसी भी SHG को लोन मिल सकता है, but उस SHG का वो SHG promote करना चाहिए among their members the saving habits. Alright. Now under the program, banks provide loan to SHGs for income generating activities. For social needs like education, health, marriage, and also for debt swaps. मतलब कि अगर बाहर से उसने किसी किसी person ने, let's say there is a member of SHG A, and this member has taken a loan from any NBFC. Let's say कि किसी एक finance company से उसने लिया हुआ है. Let's say there is a finance company X at a high rate of interest of 10%. So in this case, banks will provide under this program, banks will provide rate at the lower interest rate and the debt will be swapped. ठीक है, जो भी X का पैसा है वो bank उसको दे देगा और जो भी debt होगा वो किसके पास आ जाएगा, जो loan amount होगा वो किसके account में चला जाएगा, इसके account में. लेकिन अब वो loan देगा कौन, वो वाला bank. ठीक है, and interest rate is decided by banks. There is no fixed interest rate. जो भी बैंक का डिस्क्रिप्शन होता है उसी के हिसाब से इंटरेस्ट रेट पे लोन दिया जाता है. ओके, सो वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट रिगार्डिंग दिस. सो इट वॉज लॉन्च बाई नबार्ड इन 2002. It was launched by NABARD but not in 2002. It was in 1992 and it was launched as a pilot program. But अभी ये बहुत अच्छी performance दे रहा है. The program was launched on the recommendation of SK Mohanty Committee. No, it was SK Kalia Committee. All right. And only registered SHGs are eligible to avail the loans from participating banks. No, registered and unregistered. दोनों तरीके के SHGs इसमें से loan ले सकते हैं. But the condition is that SHG should be promoting saving habits among the members. All right. So all the statements are incorrect here, which means option D, none is correct, will be the correct answer. So that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Next session will be on Friday. So I'll see you on Friday. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.